Was there anything you wanted to say about the greater good science? And I didn't ask you a lot about that, but that probably feeds into what we're talking about too, the juxtaposition. And, you know, so you've been the director. You created this.
Yeah. So
talk about that.
So, you know, one of the things, you know, one of the things I'm most proud of out of life at Berkeley is the Greater Good Science Center. And 13 or 14 years ago, we got a gift from the Hornadays, who are alumni of Berkeley. They just lost their daughter to early death of cancer. And they're, you know, it's kind of in the aftermath of 9/11. And there's a lot of deep questioning about where we are as a culture. And they were like, we want to build something that makes as many people in the world happy as possible. And I think that I, you know, was starting to teach human happiness at Berkeley, and a lot of the data were saying that, you know, if we go after materialistic things, it doesn't make us happy. If we create inequality, it makes us less happy. If we work too hard, it makes us less happy. So we're, and this is this age-old question that was very poignant at the time, what makes us happy? And so we created, out of their gift, the Greater Good Science Center. And what it does is it takes the seven or so big themes in the happiness stress literature, and they're familiar themes for great organizations: gratitude, mindfulness, generosity, compassion, being empathetic. And we take the best science, we distill it into very viral, readable essays, and now we've built out something called Greater Good in Action, which is, if you are interested in developing a practice at work or in your family or at your school around these themes of gratitude and empathy and compassion, what we've been talking about, here's what you can do, right? Here's a little 1-minute exercise you can do that's been tested by science. The idea is to take the science and just give it away, right, to schools and hospitals and nurses and prisoners and teachers and organizations and Google and so forth and Facebook. And we have about 1 million visitors to the website each year. We've got institutes for teachers and lots of stuff happening in the workplace. So it's right there for free, greatergood.berkeley.edu. And we hope that, you know, people take it and then they do with it what they're uniquely designed to do.
Mm-hmm. Is there science around, I mean, we all know that when we give, we feel good. Is there actual data?
Oh, yeah.
What happens in the brain?
Yeah, no, that's, you know, that's an amazing story, which is, you know, we've thought way too narrowly about self-interest and happiness, you know, and you survey the average American. I think it's changing though, but like 15 years ago, to be like, oh, it's really about making more money. Then I get my self-interest is enhanced, having more material goods, experiencing more personal pleasures. That's the game. That's what Adam Smith was interested in, and that's what drives healthy societies forward. And that's partially true. But there's this new science on, and it makes sense when you go back in the deep evolutionary story of how collective and collaborative we are. You know, we're the only primate that really kind of gathers food and hunts and feeds each other and shares food, right? And you could go on with examples like that. And what happened is our brains became wired so that we actually enjoy giving things away, right? Which doesn't make sense from a very narrow view of self-interest. So brain studies find if somebody gives me some money, it activates an old part of the brain called the ventral striatum, where dopamine circuits are, and that's it's experienced as reward. But when I give that money away, I have the same active pattern of activation. Giving has the same brain reward activation as receiving. There are other studies that show, even more on point, that if I give money away, I get a boost in my happiness. And if I spend it on a materialistic desire, my happiness goes down, right? There are other studies that show if I give resources away, the people that I'm working with in an organization will do better work. and they'll respect me more. So it's been built into us to share.
Does that relate then to why people are good mentors? You know,
yeah.
Is that a giving?
Oh yeah, you know, and I think that probably the defining characteristic of who's identified as great mentors and leaders is their generosity, right? Is their that and it's in some sense in the service of their own self-interest, because their careers will end, right? Their organizations will end. And their legacy is defined by who carries on their traditions, right? Do they give away tools and ideas and resources and opportunities that keep things going? So there are a lot of reasons to give.